So let's talk about the what, the how, and the why. When our patients come in, sometimes they want to know different things. Sometimes they want to know, how did I get hurt? Sometimes they want to know, what is hurt? Sometimes they want to know, you know, why is this happening to me? Kind of questions. And, you know, it's super individual. There's lots of different factors to think about. I think medicine has gotten really good at the what. It's like, okay, we can take an MRI or we can go to somebody and they can say, this is what's wrong with you in all sense. Or, hey, I can point and it's like, yes, that tissue right there, that is probably what's giving you pain. Then we start getting into the how, like, how did this happen? And I think that this is, you know, we spend a lot of time on the how and the why, and really looking at things in like a 360 view. So when we start in like how and why, it's like, well, are there some like mechanical dysfunctions? Is there some sort of repetitive overloading that might be going on? If it was just a blunt force trauma, like you fell and sprained your ankle or something like that, that's pretty obvious. But sometimes these things, you know, usually the things that people kind of put off for a long time have kind of slowly come on and they're just not resolving on their own. They eventually come on in. And again, rather than give those people like, you have tendonitis, it's like, well, let's talk about why you have tendonitis and let's talk about what you're going to do to fix it. And I think that's really how we focus on physical therapy the most in working with our people and really trying to figure out, okay, why did this happen? What can we fix and what can we influence? And, you know, even down to some of the micro stuff, like how are you sleeping? How's your hydration? Like how's your stress levels? Like what's your diet like? Are we having these discussions? We are here at DeWitt PT, but, you know, we should be having these general wellness conversations with people too. And we do. And that's a big part of it. So it's a lot more than just the what. It's much more about the why and the how. And I think if you can really start to identify that on things that are actually something that you can change, this is our biggest opportunity for success in rehab and really in anything in life, but especially in the rehab world, because that's our niche, right? So if we can identify, well, what's going on, then what actionable steps can I do to change it? Sometimes it's as simple as, hey, you got some shoulder stuff, maybe your arm, you know, you're on the computer all day long. Crazy idea. Try using the mouse with your left hand. Just see how that goes, you know. And for some people, it's a game changer because we can't make you stop doing the reps that you need to do your job or to play your sport. But there are often times that we can't, or things that we can change to mitigate and allow you to heal. So that is where we come in. We're totally happy to help in this regard. But again, let's get beyond the what. Let's really get into the how and the why.